Hi guys, in this video I'll be talking about how to rig the mouth. Okay, what I'm going to do is rig the mouth and create a slider like this, so that we can easily switch between them. And I'll be doing this without using any plugin or a script. If this is the first time you're watching my videos, make sure you hit the subscribe button and click on the bell and turn on the notification, since the project files are free in the first few days of release. Okay, let's go. The first thing that I need is the different poses of the mouth. As you can see, I've created 12 poses for the mouth. And if you wanted to use this project, I'll put the link in the description below. After putting every pose in individual layers, the first thing that I need to do is create the slider here. For that, just like in previous tutorials, I pick up the rectangle tool and double click on it, so a shape as a comp size would be created. After that, in the rectangle, I set its roundness to 20. I have to change its size. Since I have 12 poses and want to put every pose in 100 pixels, I need 1200 pixels. So I set the X to 1200 and Y to 100. I name the layer frame. I duplicate it and call it the slider. I open the layer and set its size to 100. So such a slider would be created. And for the frame to cover the slider, I add 10 pixels to both the X and Y sizes of the frame. And then I set the stroke to 5 pixels. Okay, after that, to zero the slider position, I parent it to the frame layer. And to put the slider at the beginning of the frame right here, I go to the frame layer and change the X position so the layer would be placed here. I set it to 550. And then I place the slider in the center of the scene. And to place the different poses of the mouth in the slider, I select the poses and hit Ctrl D. I put them above and change their label color so they would be obvious. And I set their scale to 30 for now. And I place them right here. I make this smaller. I open the position of the slider. I add 100 pixels to X position. And I continue like this and place the layers in positions in order. After I'm done with it, I place the letters that associate with the pose under each one of them. For that, I pick up the type tool and draw a square like this. The letters of the first pose are these, so I write them here. I duplicate it and place it here. For it to be aligned and right under each layer, I specify each layer middle using rulers and then I place the letters below them. The next pose associates with the letter U, so I type U here. I hit Ctrl D and I place it here. The next letter is O. Again, I hit Ctrl D and I place it here. First, I duplicate the layers and then I change the letters. I hold Shift so the layers would snap to the rulers. Okay, I don't need the rulers anymore, so I hide them from here. After that, I create a triangle for the slider right here. I enable its fill and disable its stroke. And I add a round corner to it. Then I change the color of the strokes to this layer. I do the same for fill. I don't need this stroke, so I delete it. Okay, after I'm done with how the slider looks, it's time to do the rigging. For that, I open the position of the slider. I separate it. And for the slider not to move up and down, first I hold Alt and click on the stopwatch of the Y position. And in the expression box, I type 0, so the slider wouldn't move up and down. I don't want the slider to move like this. I want it to snap to the poses. To do so, since the distance between poses is 100 pixels, I'll be using the math round expression. For that, I hold Alt and left click on the stopwatch of the X position and type math.round. In the parentheses, I type value, which means the current property, and then I divide it by 100. After the parentheses, I multiply it by 100. And now let's see how it works. Now, as you can see, the slider jumps and snaps in every 100 pixels and it works perfectly. After that, to limit the slider to the frame, first I define this phrase as our variable. At the end of it, I put a semicolon. And then in the next line, I use the clamp command. In the parentheses, first I type our variable and then I specify its range. The range of the variable or the X position was from 0 to 1200. So I type 0 and 1200 right here. Let's check it out. As you can see, it doesn't go to the left, and on the right, it goes a bit further. So I set this to 1100. And as you can see, once that's done, I can easily switch between different poses. After the slider job is over, now it would be time to rig the poses. First, I shade the layers that are for the slider, and then lock them. I also change the text color, and then I shade them, And I like them too, so they won't be selected. I like the frame as well, so the only layer that can be selected is the slider. Okay, let's go for rigging the mouth. I make the mouth poses visible. Let me unsolder the layers. And then I like these layers again. Okay, the thing that I need to do is when the slider is in this position, this pose would be shown. So first of all, I open the opacity of this layer. In the expression box, I have to define the X position of the slider here. So first, I write a slider as a variable, so I can define the X position of the slider here. At the end of the line, I put a semicolon. In the next line, I'll be using the if and else command. I type if and then parenthesis. Then I want to say if the slider, which is the X position of the slider, was equal to 0, which is the same now, as a result, the opacity of this layer would be 100. So I type 100 here. Else means when the slider isn't 0, this layer would be hidden. So I type 0, so the opacity would be 0. Okay, let's test it out. When the slider is here, the layer is visible. Now, if I move the slider, as you can see, the layer will be hidden. And the opacity is 0. I do the same for the other layers too. I copy the expression by right-clicking on the opacity and choosing copy the expression only. I select other layers, open their opacity, then select them all and hit Ctrl V. The next position of the slider is 100, so 0 of the second layer should be on 100 instead. As you can see, now the layer is visible. If I go back, this layer would be visible, and this one would be hidden. It's clear from their opacity. I continue like this and increase each expression by 100. Okay, now let's see if the slider works well or not. As you can see, by moving the slider on each pose, that pose would be visible down here. And for animating it, you can use keyframes and create different poses. And you should know that the keyframes should be set to toggle hold. If you don't set them to toggle hold, let me show you. As you can see, the animation of the poses would be a mess and you wouldn't be able to control it well. If you're interested in rigging and creating different poses for your character and you want to learn how to rig all character parts and learn the expressions which are needed in this context and makes yourself needless in this field, I suggest you to enroll in my course because it can help you improve your rigging skills even further. Click the link in the description.